Second seed, North Carolina, taking on the 3 seed, James Madison, at the women's lacrosse semifinal in Stony Brook, New York. James Madison making their second semi appearance and first since 2000. They had a season opening win against North Carolina. In fact, they've lost just once on the year. They start off quickly in this one. Hannah Haven scores her 42nd goal of the season. Then it's Haley Warden with a change of direction. She scores her 38th, and it's 2-0 at that point. They let it 3-0 and then 3-1 later, but UNC comes fighting back to freshman sensation Jamie Ortega. Her 67th goal on the year, and it's 3-2 James Madison. The Dukes respond again with Warden and Haven once more. Warden quick enough here as she makes the Tar Heels pay with her second goal. Then Haven tallies her second of the game, beating the defender and scoring with the low shot here. Watch it one more time. James Madison at this point up 3-5-2. Later it's 5-3, and just as the man advantage ends, the Tar Heels add another. Olivia Ferrucci scores her second of the game, and it's 5-4, so the Tar Heels right back in this thing. Later in the first half, 6-4, the senior Warden taking over again, going to work. Gets the pass from Katie Kerrigan and scores. Then, with the roll dodge and the spin, Warden scores her fourth of the half. We got another look for you, and it's 8-4. James Madison really looking good in the first half, and they're playing defense as well. Watch the Duke's goalkeeper, Molly Dougherty, coming up big. She gets the save against UNC star Maria McCool. And just before the end of that half, James Madison feeling good in the second half. Ella Hazard drawing up a lot of attention here. She gets it to Ortega, who scores for the third time. Finished with four on the game, and it's 8-5. James Madison, a three-goal edge. Later in the second half, same score. More Ward getting the pass and finding some space as she scores for a fifth time. It's 9-5, James Madison. Later, it's 10-6, James Madison in front. Kristen Gaudian gets into the act in the second half. She scores her second consecutive goal from the free position to give the Dukes a 5-goal lead. How about that? It's 11-6. And Gaudian adding another, slicing and dicing the Tar Heels D. She scores her third goal and 77th on the year. James Madison ends up winning this one 15-12 as they advance to the national championship. It's semifinal action in women's lacrosse. Actually, a rematch of last year's final. Maryland, the national champions, taking on Boston College. And we get you started with first half action. The Terps, Callie Hartshorn, gets the pass in the middle and a great placement on this shot as Maryland doubles its early lead. There's another look at it. She scored 4 goals, and of course, she's pumped. The Terrapins up 2-0. It's 6-2 later in the first half. Maryland led 3-0, then 6-2 before this. Boston College run, Sam Apuzzo. A great individual effort here for her first goal of the game, and watch her afterward. Wonderful reaction, just slams down her stick right there. It's 6-3. Boston College inspired now. Kaylin Hart, great effort here, finally gets the space and scores. Then it's Kara Urbank with too many moves for her defender, who falls to the ground as Urbank ties the game up at 6 apiece, so BC just storming back in this thing. There's another look at it. Urbank had 3 goals in the game. We're knotted at 6 apiece. 7-6, BC after 5 consecutive goals. Jen Giles finally answers for the Terps. With 2 defenders on her, she imposes her will to tie things up. She had 3 goals and 3 assists. Now 8-7, Maryland. BC's Tess Chandler, a great effort with the catch and finish from a tough angle as this one goes in, and at the half, we're tied at 8 apiece. What a game, second half. Tremendous back and forth here. Dempsey Arsenal from behind the net gets just enough space to get the goal and the lead. She had 3 goals and 2 assists, and Maryland on the attack. Hartshorn's pass is nicely caught by Grace Griffin, who does the rest and ties things up at 13 apiece. Then it's Apuzzo's turn. Going to work behind the net. She leaves her defender on the ground. Then she's knocked down, scores the goal ahead, goal anyway. And yeah, we got to take another couple of looks at this one from Apuzzo. That made it 14-13 BC. And this is just all individual effort, just dropping folks on the ground before she takes a little contact, falls herself, and finishes this one off. Heroic effort from Apuzzo. who gives the first two-goal advantage for any team in the second half when she caps the scoring here as Boston College goes on to win this thing 15-13. They advance to the championship.